Hello and welcome to another iRacing video. Welcome to the Red Bull Ring for the Global Fanatec Challenge. So our Cadillacs have gone and they are about to cross the start line. So we are going to get the green lights any moment now, probably just as we enter this last corner.
Go, go, go.
There we go. So we did manage to qualify on pole for this one. We do have Mike, who's a 4.4k driver in the race. I don't know what his pace is like because he didn't set a lap in qualifying. So it will be interesting to see how we fare. So this is my second race here today. The first race was, if I'm honest, more of a mic headset test, as I've just changed them. So Mike is asserting his authority by looks of it, by jumping up to second. So won't be long before he cruises up behind, I'm sure. That's going to be all about trying to keep these tyres in shape. These long radius corners here at the Red Bull Ring. We have some. Oh, we've got a Cadillac way off the circuit. As Mike touched on at the end of qualifying, it's really easy to get an off track here. So let's see how we can get on. So if we can come away with a reasonably clean race, could get ourselves back into the fours of the safety rating. Mike's just gone quite wide there. I wonder if he got a slowdown or whether he's managed to survive the dreaded slowdown.
Thank you, 14.
So he is still within slipstream territory, being 1 second behind. I don't think I've actually raced Mike in the kit. I'm sure I've seen him in a spec yellow racer flag challenge race. Oh. Nope, we're okay. Just want to be a bit cautious there because I'm not too sure if we're going to find a Cadillac somewhere. A little bit slidey there. And again, that's a bit deeper than I'd like. That could be an off track. Oh no, we survived it, we survived it. Luckily, Mike may have gone slightly wide too. Oh, it's so easy to touch that yellow curb. You touch that yellow curb on the inside, you are getting an off track.
You're in the lead.
Same on this yellow curb on the inside here. Drift over the one on the left, and there's another off track. It is actually really quite easy, but at the same time, I think they've eased them up a little bit. Similar. Look at Mike's lap. 1:37.423. Closed him right up on my tail.
Thank you.
Oh, still not great. But better than last lap.
Thank you.
Definitely back in the slipstream.
Sector 1 is quick. Sector 2 is 2/10 off the pace. Sector 3 is 0.2 off the pace.
Now, if Mike's seen my other videos, he knows what I'm like when he comes to cars right behind. Don't distract me. You know what I'm like, Jim. Got a Cadillac coming through. Mike's got himself nicely back in that slipstream. Where's this faster car going to come through?
Thanks for waiting, Jason.
Here we go.
It's the fastest lap of the race.
I could ruin my race up and then finish the battle.
Yeah, thanks, man.
On your right. Still there. Clear right. Left side. Still there. Still there. Still there. Yellow flag. Still there.
Still I was there. Too sure it was going to fight there.
Car left. Hold your line. Hold your line. Hold your line. Still there.
Ooh, a little touchy-touchy. Oh, this could be awkward.
Still there. Still there.
Ooh.
Hold your line. Hold your line.
Wrong position completely.
You're in the middle. Still there. You're
oh, this right. Could be.
Left side. Clear all round, V2.
Oh, Jim. Alright.
Yeah, thanks for your patience there, Jason. I hope it was entertaining.
Yeah, thanks, Jason. Appreciate it. Now, the question is, can I stay with Mike? This lap time is phenomenal, a 37.0. Is it easier to follow than it is to lead? That's the question. got to be a, that's either going to be enough. That's got to be a good off track.
Right, slow down.
Okay, Ian, keep under pressure. He'll make a mistake. 15 minutes remaining. 15 minutes to go. Car left. Clear left.
Oh, that's going to be wide.
Well played, fella.
Well played, Mike.
He's got it. And there we go.
Car right. Still there. Still there. Hold your line. Right side's clear.
Alright, come on. Let's try and stay with Mike as much as we can. Keep him under pressure. Don't know. It just feels that Mike's sliding that car a bit more than me. Sometimes difficult to judge that, because what you see on your screen is not always 100% what's happening on theirs. Let's just see if we can keep it calm and see if we can hold on to these tyres, try and do something later in the race. Get any message to say we touched. That's close though. Still getting that slipstream.
Stay close.
Need to, Jim. I need to. I'm trying so hard, Jim, to stay with Mike.
Halfway home. Fuel looks good.
Ooh, that's got to be wide for Mike.
Left side. Still there. He's still there. Hold your line. Clear left.
Oh, Mike's got a much better exit. I don't want to throw away a good race by having a clash.
39.0. 0.7 off the pace.
You do get quite a jolt through the steering wheel if you catch that inside curb.
Okay, Ian, stay close. Wait for him to make a mistake.
Oh, that could be an off track. Oh, Mike's definitely got a pull on me there. Oh, we've got a white flag. Too wide. 10 minutes to go. Ooh. I have to admit, that was getting a bit cozy. Definitely felt my wheels lock up badly there. Oh, I've gone off track. A little bit too wide. On the entry. To know how many off-tracks Mike's getting. Maybe it's not as many as I think, and I'm not using as much of the circuit as I could. Position though, I might have a little bit more pace. I don't know, it just feels like I'm just got a little bit more there. I don't know, difficult to judge. Do you think he's been sliding the car a bit more than I have? Whether I've got a little bit more, well, good for that. Still lots of time to go. Just trying my hardest to keep with him. Just keep him under pressure. See if I can make him work his tyres that little bit more. Just use the slipstream to keep me there. This is either going to work or fail miserably. Off tracks he's on. I really do.
That one was at 38.2. 5 minutes to go. This is good. We'll be on the podium if we can keep it together.
Come on, Jim. I'm trying. There was no, didn't come up as contact, but I've definitely touched Mike.
I think it worked and it was.
Right, we have got 3 or so minutes. We've got the leader coming through, so we've got probably 2 laps. I don't know, we might not get lapped. I don't, it's difficult because if we don't get lapped, we'll have an extra lap. At some point I'm gonna have to try, I think, a move. If I can stay close enough to actually get to make a move, that is. Another off track.
Stewart, just behind the track. Keep it between white lines. Two minutes.
We're going to finish this lap. Yes, we are. The leader in the Cadillacs is 7.5 seconds behind, so we're going to have 2 more laps.
Car right. Clear right.
We're going to have to take the off track, Jim.
Stay between the lines, please, Ian.
Just can't quite get the traction out of the corner, Jim. This is why we go racing. Oh, that's a little bit deeper than I would have liked. I think Mike might be struggling with his tyres as well. Get another lap after this, sorry, although the leader is closing in. If he passes us, this is the last lap.
All right,
doesn't pass us. He's got a huge lead, so there's no reason that he has to pass us. Oh, Mark's... Mike parked it on the apex, well there. Get another lap, I think. He's in no hurry, is he? We have. Come on, Jim!
Right side. He's still there. Clear right.
Go right through one.
Oh, no!
Yeah, good race.
Gear was a bit rubbish there. This is going to be next to impossible to overtake now.
Car right. He's still there. Clear right.
Oh! That was fantastic!
Awesome race, Ian. One of the best races I've ever
made. Oh, that was superb, that was superb. Loved it, Mike, loved it. Oh,
yes. Like, I don't even know if we got any zero X's, but like we were side by side for about four laps, I think, or it felt like
Oh,
it.
That was amazing! Oh, that was amazing. Thank you very much, Mike. Yes.
Oh, well, likewise, mate. Thank you.
Yes, that's why we go racing. Wow. Wow. Yes. Definitely one of my best races, that one. Right, let's get this pulled over and let's have a look at the incidents. Whew. Oh, well done, Mike.
Yeah, the tyres really, really go off on them, don't they? Like, they're great for about, feels like four or five laps. And then the last four or five, it's, yeah.
Yeah, it is trying to hang on to them. They are, yeah. Interesting. Right, let's have a look at the incidents. That was an amazing race. Absolutely amazing. I don't care that I came second. Absolutely loved it. Right. Race start. The gas start was all right, actually. So, I do like the classic livery that Mike uses there as well. That's from the Nissan that was in the British touring cars quite some years ago. Mm. Cadillac. Oh, got a Kia. It's going to go a bit wide, I think, is it? No. Oh, blown engine. Blown engine in Kia. Oh, blink up. Spin up. Oh, dear. Oh, well avoided. Well avoided. Number seven. Ten's going a bit wild. That's going to send you off if you accelerate on that stuff. It's the icy grass. Oh dear. Oh. Oh, we'll get a lot of curbs in this. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to see if I can at least find. Maybe the last couple of laps with myself and Mike. I'm not sure how many laps we actually got to in the race. There was a couple though, that was just great side by side. How many laps did we get? This is the last lap, because the Cadillac lead has just finished. Let's just watch this last lap run out. I gave it my best, Jim. I gave it my best, but it wasn't quite good enough. But the race was awesome. Currently hear Matt Malone in my ear saying, you should have tried something different. You should have tried something different. He's right. I should have done. I ended up doing the same thing into that corner, just going on the outside and hoping I'd be able to get the switch back. But never quite got it. Oh, this is where we got kind of close. We went side by side. And then you get to that moment where you almost get a bit nervous because you're like, I don't want to wreck what has already been an amazing race. Oh, I was really hoping if Mike defending, I'd had to pinch him a little bit, but you've got to give people room. I've got to know how many off tracks he's got. Because he's got a few, surely. Oh, I've not been using all the circuit, and there's more for me to use. There you go, that's the end of the race. Oh, dear. Right. Let's have a look. I unfortunately didn't get the safety rating I was probably hoping for from that. There we go. Let's see. I was so close. I was on 3.99. Oh dear. Oh well. There we go. So we have two splits for this one. Ours was a 2.5k split. As I've mentioned already, I've lost 0.12 on the safety rating, but I did at least gain 18 on the I rating. So in the Cadillacs, we have Marcus, Jordan, and Brian in our top three. And it's going to be Jordan, I believe, with the plus 54 as our biggest I-rate gain in the Cadillacs. And our biggest loser in the Cadillacs looks to be Jason with a minus 53. Shout out to Jason, who was really good and held back to let myself and Mike fight. And then in our Kia Optima race, it was Mike, myself, and Preston in the top three. And I think it's Mike that's come away with the biggest I-rating gain. He's gained 36. And it looks like it's Carsten here who has the biggest loss with a minus 36. Fastest laps were pretty close, but it has to be said we were pushing each other all over the place. That's what I wanted to know. So that suggests I'm not using as much of the circuit as I could, because he's only got 5, and it looked from my angle that he would have got more than that. So I clearly need to make use of some of those exits a bit more. Not using them enough. Well, there we go. What a race. What a race. That is right up there. I thought last week's race at Le Mans was great, but that's topped that one already. How amazing can you get? Within 2 weeks, I've had 2 amazing races. The Kia is good. See, it's good. Get good racing in the Kia, and it's free. Well, ignoring the iRacing subscription, of course. Anyway, if you've stayed here right to the end, thank you very much for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye.